Well, he took one smack on the chin there, and he's out.
Fantastic punch! What a fantastic punch from Danny Hunt! Where on earth did he find that from? He knocked Dave Keogh cold.
Ooh, and this is where Miller is dangerous. This is where Miller can unhinge Scott Baker. He used to get... Oh! And that's exactly what I was worried about. That is exactly what I was worried about. Well, Slick Miller wins in very emphatic style at the end. Emphatic winner. And, well, unfortunately for Scott Baker, he couldn't take their barrage of shots. And sadly, he's gone right out here.
Left hook from Stowe, and Moa in trouble again. Royce Knife could stop this. Stowe's showing an impressive variety of hard punches, and he's got Moet now. What a terrible shame for Matt Moet. And a good right through the middle, and that's Scott Gearan in trouble. And draped over the ropes in the first round, and he's out. Goodness me. Well, he took one smack on the chin there, and he's out. He's not going to get up from there.
I mean, these punches hurt.
Oh, jeez. Classic knockout.
He's in big trouble.
Oh, brother, he's in real trouble.
Fantastic fight this has been. Kangaroos still on the march here. Mackay still struggling on again. It's over! Referee Richie Davis waves it off. And then Daru lands a crunching right hand.
Well, again, a cracking uppercut from Burton. That's left French in really a bad condition. I mean, cracking win in the third round there for Graham Burton. Ushered back to his corner by Brendan Ingle. And certainly hope that... Terry French is okay.
And his manager Pat Brogan's always had high hopes for McGee. And looking for him now to fulfill his potential as a super middle instead of a light heavy.
Oh, good left hook there. Got Paul McCarthy in this second round. He's not going to beat this count. No, it's been stopped. Referee Jim Pridding counts him out for an excellent second round knockout win there for Noel McGee.
Right there from Bradley. Ooh, good left hook from him. Good to see. He won't get up from that. He's out. Oh, what a shame. An excellent win there for Bradley, and it was always on the cards with that left hook. What a comeback for him. I've never seen Williams knocked out before.
Dallas's balance isn't exactly right as yet, but there you come. Nice little jab there.
Well, I'm not so sure it was the strength of the punch, more the...
Let's go with both hands. Shoulders and shoulders. Moves. Oh, what a crunching right there! The Tony Whitehouse face down on the canvas.
Patrick Kamey versus Mitchell King. And King from Loughborough. Patrick Kamey, originally from Uganda, round one. 6-2 is this one. Kamey with those spidery arms. And Mitchell King trying to find a way through here. Oh, what a fantastic right hand there from Patrick Kamey, and Mitchell King surely will not beat the count here. Fantastic punch.
9, 10.
If he manages to get Buston in trouble. He's got deceptively long arms as well, yeah.
Oh, a crunching left hook there. That's got Buston out of the ring in this second round. Well, he's not going to make it back, that's for sure. And referee John Keane has called the doctor.
Well, that, he went down extremely heavily there, did Buston. Distance with his shots is Gaffara.
And down he goes. Goodness me, what a punch that was. I don't think he'll beat it. It's all over. The new WBC middleweight international middleweight champion, Kid Marlo from Birmingham. On a 10th round knockout.
One then. Ainsley Bingham against the Welshman, Tony Britland.
Sharp and weak.
Exploratory jabs here so far. Oh, and a beautiful left hook there from Ainsley Bingham, and Tony Britland flat on his back here in the first round, less than 20 seconds on the clock. And the timekeeper has counted him out. A great win for Ainsley Bingham.